Friends of Patricia Jessamy are demanding the man running for her position as city state's attorney pull one of his latest TV ads immediately. They say it's offensive to a family killed in a firebombing nearly 10 years ago. 11 News reporter David Collins joins us live from the Mitchell Courthouse with more on the story. David?
Stan, one of the most controversial claims in that ad alleges the state's attorney's office mismanaged its witness protection program. We dug up a 2003 interview with the woman in charge of it, and what she said then appears to contradict what she says now.
It's offensive, it's insensitive, and it's unacceptable.
For someone to politicize an issue is just unconscionable.
Dawson family friends, the NAACP, and numerous elected officials are demanding that this political TV ad be pulled from the airwaves and anywhere else the public can see it.
We lost 5 children and their parents.
The political ad from the Greg Bernstein campaign revisits the firebombing that took the lives of the Dawson family back in 2002. Angela Dawson had a reputation for reporting drug dealing and other crimes in her neighborhood to police. The ad uses material from an unsuccessful $14 million lawsuit the Dawson family filed years ago, claiming the city failed to provide reasonable police and witness protection services.
Because the state's attorney's office mismanaged the program.
The woman making the claim is DeTanya Madden, the former witness security coordinator for the city state's attorney's office. Back in 2003, 11 News interviewed Madden about the Dawson case. She asked not to be photographed. At the time, we obtained a referral form sent from her office to an assistant prosecutor in connection with the Dawson case. We also uncovered one of Madden's own emails, revealing correspondence before the firebombing, asking whether she had talked with the Dawson family, as suggested by an assistant prosecutor.
It's not the responsibility of the prosecutor or the police to offer protection. They can make a referral for protection, but it's not their place to offer protection.
But according to the office guidelines, they do have the authority to have witnesses fill out the form, then it goes to the coordinator. At the time of the firebombing, former city police commissioner Ed Norris told 11 News the police offered the Dawson family witness protection. News stories at the time indicate the family declined.
Angela emphatically said, "No drug dealers will drive me out of my community."
The Bernstein campaign says Madden approached them, saying she believed the city state's attorney's office failed to protect the Dawson family. The campaign says it has no plans to pull any of its ads.
Bernstein's need to withdraw the ad, and the NAACP can agitate, we can rally, and we will demonstrate.